morning everybody. I am Rama Devi, working as a chemistry faculty in Target English Medium School at Talipatta. Today, I am going to explain this video for 10th class students. That is, in past video, I clearly explained the main principles depend upon the how we write the electronic configuration. Those are three principles. One is Pauli's exclusion principles, that was completed in past video. Now, two more principles I explained clearly. Those are Abbau principle and Hund's principle. A very important question. Write the three principles. Depend upon these three principles, how we write the electronic configuration. Like that also they are asked. Or indirectly they are asked. Depend upon the principle statement. Okay. So, the second principle is Abbau principle. What is the second principle, Anna? Abbau principle. Abbau principle. A very important for 2 marks also. Or for 3 principles they are asked for 4 marks totally. Individually they are asked for 2 marks. Or either 1 mark question also, or compulsory 3 principles they are asked means 4 marks question also sometimes they are asked. So, what is the Abbau principle means? Actually, the Pauli's exclusion principle said, what is the statement? There are no 2 electrons can have the 4 set of quantum numbers are same. Means, based on the Pauli exclusion principle, we have concluded the subshell or a orbital must be contain the 2 electrons. More than 2 electrons, there is no orbital can hold. Are you understand, Anna? Based on that principle, we have concluded an orbital can hold only 2 electrons. More than 2 electrons, it is not possible for each and every orbital or shell. Yes, that is the Pauli's exclusion principle. Now, what is Abbau principle means? In Pauli's, I explained the helium atom for example. Okay. For example, if more than 2 electrons are presented in an atom, how the electrons are assigned in their suitable orbitals? Are you understanding that? If more than 2 electrons are presented in any atom, how the electrons are assigned in their suitable orbitals? That is our question. For that answer, we have going to explain the Abbau principle and also Hund's principle. Okay. So, for example, when increase the atomic number of an atom, increase the number of electrons in that atom or element. Are you understand? For example, lithium. Atomic number is 3. 1s2, 2s1. How we assign these 1 electron in the 2s? The two electrons are entered into the 1s orbital. Then the third electron was entered into the 2s orbital. Why? Because means any orbital can hold only 2 electrons. More than 2 electrons is not possible, already we said. So for s orbital, what is the maximum capacity of number of electrons is only 2. So that's why 1s orbital can hold 2 electrons. Then after it was entered into the 2s. Are you understand? How we can write this electronic configuration means depend upon the Abbau principle. I will say what is the statement means. Abbau is a German word. Abbau is a German word. That is, the meaning is building up. The meaning is a building up. Very important. What is Abbau meaning, Anna? It is a German word. What is the meaning of Abbau means? Building up. Building up means lower to higher. How do we can construct a building? From the base is there. Then after we have to build the building or any construction also we have started from the base onwards. Okay, are you understand? So, like that here also, the electrons are assigned in the lower energy orbitals first. Then the electrons are entering to the higher energy orbitals. Are you understand, Anna? So it is also called as increasing energy values. depending upon the increasing energy values, the electrons are assigned. So, what is the Aufbau means? Aufbau is a German word. That is, the meaning is building up. So, Aufbau principle is also called building rule. It is also called na building rule. It is also called building rule. So, what is the statement means? The statement was, lower energy orbitals are filled first. Then higher energy orbitals filled next.
L is what, angular momentum quantum number. Here L is
एंगुलर मोमेंटम क्वांटम नंबर here L is angular momentum quantum number and if L is equals to 0 or 1, 2, 3 and so on the maximum number of electrons in S, P, D, F, R 2, 6, 10, 14, and so on. Here also, and so on. G, G is also there, orbital. Okay. Again, I repeat here, very important. Listen, this is also important for big purpose. What is the formula for maximum number of electrons in a shell? The maximum number of electrons in a particular shell is 2n square. Here, n is the principal quantum number. 2 into 1 square, if the principal quantum number 1 is there, that is 2 into 1 square, I already told to you. Here I explained, listen carefully. 2n square is the formula, okay. N is the principal quantum number. If the n value is 1, that is belongs to which shell, na? K shell. So, 2 into 1 square, how many number of electrons? 2. So, K shell having the only 2 electrons. If n is equals to 2, that is belongs to the L shell. So 2 into 2 square, 2 square is 4, that is 4, 2 is 8, so L shell belongs to the 8, like that, if n is equal to 3, what is the shell, Nana? M shell, so 2 into 3 square, 18, so M shell having the 18 electrons, so if n is equal to 4, what is the N, which shell, Nana? M shell, 2 into 4 square, 2 into 4 square, 4, 4, 16, 16, 2 is 32, so N shell having the maximum number of electrons are 32. Are you understand, Nana? Once you listen there, I'll write there, ma. 2N square is the maximum number of electrons in N shell. Once you observe there, 2N square is the maximum number of electrons in N shell. The N value is 1. Already I call this basic concept. If the N value is 1, that is belongs to the K shell. Okay, the K shell having the maximum number of electrons are 2. How we find 2 into 1 square is equals to 2. Okay, 1 is the principal quantum number value. If the N value is equals to 1, that is K. K shell having the 2 into 1 square is equals to 2 electrons. So, K shell can be filled with only 2 electrons. If N is equals to 2, what is the shell? L shell. L shell having the maximum number of electrons are 8. How we find out 2 into 2 square? 2 square nothing but 4. 2 2 is 4. 4 2 is 8. N is equal to 3. That is belongs to which shell, Nana? M shell. So 2 into 3 square. How much, Nana? 18. Next up. If N is equal to 4, what is the shell, Nana? N shell. Okay. So in N shell, how many maximum number of electrons are presented? Means 32 electrons. One you observe there, my last. Last point you observe carefully there. Based on the 2n square formula, we have to find out in K shell how many electrons, in L shell how many electrons, in M shell how many electrons, in N shell how many electrons. K having the 2 electrons, L the maximum number of electrons are 8. In M, the maximum number of electrons are 18. In N, the maximum number of electrons are 32. If you have if you don't have this information in your running notebook, write this. Otherwise, no need. Are you understand, ma? If don't you have this information in your running notebook, means write in that. Otherwise, no need this information. This information only. This is a must be you have to write continue also. This is the above principle. Third point, first one is the maximum number of electrons in N shell is 2N square. Here N is the principal quantum number. Next point is the electrons are filled in the suitable orbitals, that is 2 into 2L plus 1 formula. Here L is the principal angular momentum quantum number. And if L value is 0, that is belongs to S orbital, I already told to you. Again I repeat, the electrons are filled in their suitable orbitals depending upon the how. We are decided means depending upon the 2 into 2L plus 1 formula. Here L is the angular momentum quantum number. If L value is a 0, that is derived to SR beta. If L value is 1, that is PR beta. If it is a 2, that is DR beta. If L value is a 3, that is FR beta. Okay. So, depending upon, now you can introduce the L value, that is 0 in this formula. 0 in this formula. I write here, this one. And I write here. Now, you can observe carefully. Here you observe, Nana, after this point you can write this. So, 2 into 12 plus 1. If L value is a 0, that is belongs to the SR beta. Depending upon this formula, we find out in SR beta how many maximum number of electrons are presented. See, if L is a 0, 2 into 0 plus 1, how much? 2 into 0 plus 1, 1. So, 2 into 1, how much, Nana? 2. So, if L value is equal to 0, that is belongs to the S orbital. In S orbital, the maximum number of electrons are 2. Again, I repeat here. If L is equal to 1, again you introduce the 1 value in 2 half 2L plus 1 formula. 2 into 2, 2 half, 2 into 1 plus 1. See, Nana? 2 half 2L plus 1 formula. L value is here 1. If L value is 1, that is belongs to which orbital? P orbital. So, P orbital having the maximum number of electrons are 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3. 2, 3 is 6. 2 into 3, 6. So, in P orbital, the maximum number of electrons are 6. Like that, we are introducing the L values in 2 half 2L plus 1 formula. We get the, that is, 2 electrons are presented in the S orbital. 6 electrons are presented in the p orbital, 10 electrons are presented in the d, 14 electrons are presented in the f. There is a g and a h orbitals are also there. But up to our syllabus, up to our higher classes also, we needed only f, p, d, f orbitals. These 4 orbitals are enough. In s orbital, the maximum number of electrons are presented are 2. In p, the maximum number of electrons are 6. In D, the maximum number of electrons are 10. In F, the maximum number of electrons are 14. Up to here, are you clear, Nana? Yes. But we have one doubt. Madam, now only you said now, one question, what is that? Any orbital can hold only 2 electrons. Any orbital can hold only 2 electrons. Here, P orbital can be filled with 6 electrons. How it is possible means, in later principle, I told you in Hund's rule. In Hund's rule, I can clear about that. Actually, in P, again, subshells are there, suborbitals are there, Px, Py, Pz. Px having 2, Py having 2, Pz having 2. Means we choose the 6 electrons. Are you understand, Anna? Like that, we are given a clear idea about this question in Hund's rule. Okay? Up to here. Yes. Now, how the electrons are assigned? How? We can say that which orbital having the lower energy and which orbital can have the higher energy means rules for above principle. There are some general rules for above principle are there, Nana? What are the general rules? Can you predict for the above principle means? There are two main general rules. One is depending upon the n plus l value, depending upon the n plus l value, we assign the electrons in the orbital. Depending on the n plus l value, 1 minute more. We assign the electrons in their suitable orbitals. That is, orbitals which have the orbitals which have the lower n plus l value, which have the lower n plus l value, those orbitals are filled first. point. These are the two general rules mainly which can decide the which orbitals have the lower energy, which orbitals can have the higher energy. Depending upon the building up principle or alpha principle, I clearly said to you, lower energy orbitals are filled first, then higher energy orbitals are filled next. Means the orbitals which have the lower and which have the higher energy, how can we decide it? Means based on these two rules. One is depending upon the n plus l value, we are concluded which orbital has the lower energy and which orbital has the higher energy. Means I write it here. Orbitals which have the lower n plus l value, those orbitals are filled first. Means the orbitals which have the lower n plus l value, those are considered as lower energy orbitals. The orbitals which have the higher n plus l value, those orbitals have the higher energy than this orbital. Are you understand? For example, I do one clarification for you. 1s and 2s. 1s and 2s. Now, we can find out the n plus l value for 1s and also n plus l value for 2s. Now, you find out ma. N value is 1 here, 1 plus. What is the s here? S orbital. The s orbital is there. What is the l value? 0. 1 plus 0 is equals to 1. And 2s. What is the n plus l value? 2 plus 0. That is equals to 2. So, the orbitals which have the lower n plus l value, those orbitals are filled first. So, now you can say in 1s and 2s, compare these two orbitals which have the lower energy orbital, 1s. Why? Because the n plus l value for 1s is 1, the n plus l value for 2s is 2. So, compare these two, 1s has the lower energy compared to the 2s. That's why we can say clearly by this rule, we can say 1s is filled first, then compared to the 2s orbital. Are you understand Anna? How can you decide it? The electrons are first entered into the 1s instead of 2s orbital. You are asking like this also indirect question. The electrons are entered into the first 1s instead of 2s because depending upon the outgo principle, that is depending upon the n plus l value. 1s orbital has the lower n plus l value compared to the 2s orbital. 1s has the 1 value, that is n plus l. 2s has the 2, that is n plus l value. So, 1s has the lower n plus l value. That's why the electrons are first entered into the 1s instead of 2s. Are you understand, Anna? N plus l nothing but orbital before number is n value, Anna. If orbital s is there, l value is 0. If p is there 1, if d is there 2, if f is there 3, 0 onwards these are started. Okay? So this is the depending upon n plus l value. Okay. For suppose, second point, second rule. For suppose, if any orbitals, if any two orbitals can have the same n plus l value, how can we decide it? Which orbital is filled first and which orbital was filled next? I can say what is the next point. If two orbital has the same n plus l value, if two orbital has the same n plus l value, how can we decide it? Which orbital is filled first, which orbital is filled next? That is, yes, if two orbitals have same n plus l value, if two orbitals have same n plus l value, the orbitals which have the lower n value, those are filled first. Second rule, na? For example, we have decided what by using the first point we can conclude it. The orbital which have the lower n plus l value, those are filled first. Okay. But if two orbitals have the same n plus l value, how can we decide it? Which was the filled first and which was the filled next? That is, depending upon the n value, the orbital which have the lower n value, those orbitals are filled first. Then the orbital which have the higher n value, those orbitals are filled next. Are you understanding on this point? See carefully there. Second rule is, that is the second rule. Second general rule in the above principle. If two orbitals have the same n plus l value, that is the orbitals which have lower n value, those are filled first. Those orbitals are filled first. Then higher n value are filled next. Are you understand, Anna? I'll say example for this. Example for the second point. For example, 4s and 3p. 4s and 3p. I'll take the 4s orbital and 3p orbital. Now you can find out the n plus l value for 4s and 3p. For 4s, n plus l value 4 plus 0, that is equals to 4. For 3p, 3 plus 1, that is equals to 4. So here you observe carefully, the 4s for the n plus l value is a 4. For 3p, the n plus l value is a 4. For p orbital, l value is 1. Are you understand? So 3 plus 1 is 4. So 4s having the equal n plus l value for the 3p. Means both are having the same n plus l value. So, depending upon the second rule, we can decide which orbital is filled first in among the 4s and the 3p. Now, can you say which orbital is filled next? Either 3p or 4s? Now, can you say the answer for me? 3p or 4s, which is filled first? 3p. Why? Because in the 3p, the 3 is the lower n value compared to the 4s. I already said this here. If two orbitals have the same n plus l value, the orbitals which have the lower n value, the orbitals which have the lower n value, those are filled first. Are you understand, ma? So here, compared to the 4s and 3p, 4s and 3p, 4s orbital has the n plus l value is a 4, 3p orbital has the n plus l value is a 4. Both are having the same n plus l value. So among these two, which is filled first means I can say the 3p. Why? Because in the 3p orbital, 3p has the lower n value compared to the 4s. Here, the 3p has the lower n value compared to the 4s. That's why the electrons are first entered into the 3p instead of 4s. Are you understand, Anna? The electrons are first entered into the 3p instead of 4s. That is the above general rules. Those are two general rules. Can you predict the how the electrons are assigned into the orbital B? Depending upon the two general rules in the above principle, those are, first rule is, depending upon the n plus l value, we can decide the which orbital having the lower energy and which orbital has the higher energy. This is the orbitals which have the lower n plus l value, those orbitals are filled first. And compared to the 1s and the 2s, I say the electron was firstly entered into the 1s, because the n plus l value for 1s is 1, the n plus l value for 2s is 2. That's why the electrons are first entered into the 1s instead of 2s. Are you understand, ma'am? Yes. So, a second rule is, if the two orbitals can have the same n plus l value, how can we decide it means the orbital which have the lower n value, that orbitals are filled first, then higher, then another orbital, then another orbital compared to another orbital. So here 4s and 3p compared to those one, 3p is was filled first, then 4s was filled next. Here we can draw a diagram depending upon the above principle, that is n plus l value increasing order diagram. We can say the diagram names in two different ways. One is n plus l value increasing order diagram, and two is Mueller diagram. Mueller diagram. And some students, they ask, sometimes in the question papers, they can, means they give like the n plus l value increasing order. Depending upon that one, a diagram, you draw the diagram depending upon this statement and also explain the rest like that. That is nothing but Mueller diagram. N plus L value increasing order, or nothing but Mueller diagram. Now I got a Euler diagram or Euler chart. Then how many is our beta? In P means 2P, 3P. In P there is no 1P, one P not there, because in P again there are 3 subarbitals are there, PX, PY, PZ. Okay. 4P, 5P, 6P and 7P. In D there are 4 subarbitals are there, 3D, 4D, 5D, 6D. In F there are two series, 4F, 5F. First you write like this, the orbitals 1S to 8S, 2P to 7P, 3D to 6D, 4F to 5F. We can blindly remember 1S not there, 8S not there. Okay. For second first process 1S to 8S are there, and for second process up 1 and down 1 you can remove and write remaining one. And also for next 2P to 7P, and next for D series 2P not there, 7P not there. Up 1, down 1, you can remove one. And for 3D to 6D, then for 4F, up 1, down 1, you can remove 2 suborbitals, and remaining one you can write strictly 4F and 5F. The electrons are first entered into the lower endocell value, that is 1S, now only I say. This is n is equals to 1, here n is equals to 2, n is equals to 3, n is equals to 4, n is equals to 5, n value is equals to 6, if n value is equals to 7, n value is equals to 8, l value is equals to 0, l value is equals to 1, l value is equals to 2, l value is equals to 3 for this. For this l value is 3, that is f orbital. For D orbital L value is 2, for P L value is 1, for S orbital L value is 0. Now, okay, we said electrons are first entered into which orbital? And guys, carefully observe ma, then enter into the 2s. You can draw like this. Then after 2s, after the electrons are goes into the 2p, then after 3s, then after. Yes. Then after 3s, which orbital is given first? 3p, then 4s, then 4s after 3d, 4p, 5s. Then after 4d, 5p, 6s. Then after 4s, 5d, 6p, 7s. Are you understanding carefully? Then after 5s, the electrons are entered into, then 60, then 70, then 8s. This is the diagrammatical representation for the n plus l value increasing order. The name of diagram is n plus l value increasing order. R.O.R. Euler chart. Are you understanding? The name of the diagram is N plus L value increasing order or Euler chart or Euler diagram. See up one, Anna. L value is a 0 for 1s, all for L value is 0. For all 2p to 7p, L value is 1. For all 3d to 6d, L value is 2. For all 4f to 5f, the L value is 3. There carefully observe, Nana, there. Here, for 1s, the N value is 1. For 2s, 2p, the N value is 2, Nana. For 3s, 3p, 3d, the N value is 3, Nana. For
4S, 4P, 4D, 4F. For these row, the n value is 4, Nana. Next, 5S, 5P, 5D, 5F. For these row, n value is 5, Nana. For 6S, 6P, 6D. For these values, n value is 6, Nana. For 7S and 7P, for these two, n value is 4, Nana. For 8S, the n value is 8. Are you understood, Nana?
So, our cross is there for this. N value is equal to 7 for this. N value is equal to 8 for this. Okay. Somewhat cross. N value is equal to 6. Are you understood, Nana?
This is the Euler diagram or n plus l value increasing order. You observed carefully this diagram. First, the electrons are entered into the 1s.
1s. Like that. Then the electrons are entered into the 2s. Then are entered into the 2p. You will go from last here like this. 2p. Then 3s. Then 3p. Then 4s. Then 3d. 4p. 5s. Then 4d. 5p. 6s. Then last which one orbital? 4f. 4f. 5d. 6p. 7s. Then go for last 5F, 6B, 7B, 8S. This is the Euler diagram or N plus L value increasing order. Depending upon this diagram, you can write the ascending order of the energy levels. Ascending order of the energy levels. You can write that. Ascending order means low to high. We can write to small to big. Ascending order. Which is 1s is less than 2s less than 1s after 2s, 2s after 2p, 2p less than 3s less than 3p less than 4s. Now I write here less than 4s after which one is 3d less than 4p less than 5s. Less than 5s after 4d less than 5p less than 5p after 6s less than then after 4f less than 5d less than 6p less than 7s less than then after 5f less than 6d less than 7p than 8s. So which is the low energy 1s, which is the higher energy 8s? Are you understanding? That is the ascending order of energy levels. Ascending order of energy levels. 1s less than 2s less than 2p less than 3s less than 3p less than 4s 3d less than 4p less than 5s less than 4d less than 5p less than 6s less than 4f less than 5d less than 6p less than 7s less than 5f less than 6d less than 7p and less than finally 8s. Which is the lower energy orbital here among these one means 1s, which is the higher energy orbital 8s. So depending upon this diagram, that is n plus l value increasing order or Euler diagram, we can write the ascending order of energy levels, that is the ascending order of energy levels. They are asking like this for 1 mark also. Okay, yes.